Hello everyone, this is Rupesh Kumar Dutt and today we are going to learn about semiconductor physics. After this tutorial, you will be able to answer about questions from semiconductor theory, classification of materials, types of semiconductors and p-n junction diode. This is the small portion of a periodic table in which we are shown group 3, group 4 and group 5 elements. Group 4 elements are known as semiconductors and those are carbon, silicon and germanium. These are also known as elementary semiconductors, and if we combine group 3 and group 5 elements, then we will get compound semiconductors, and these are also very widely used for certain applications like gallium arsenide and aluminum phosphide. Now some important terms like valence electrons and covalent bonds, you all know what is this, but in semiconductors covalent bonds are very important as at very low temperature like 0 degree Kelvin, and they are very intact and they can be easily broken at room temperature. And if they break the covalent bond, then it releases free electrons and holes in pair. And holes are nothing but just the absence of electron and having a positive charge. And then if free electrons and holes are to be called in a single way, then these are carriers and they conduct the electric current in the circuit. Now just learned about what is silicon bonding. So if we have a silicon atom and it has 4 electrons and we have many silicon atoms in a lattice, then if we make these atoms to come closer, then it forms a covalent bond between its neighboring electrons, and to fill the octet rule of the silicon or any atom. This is an intrinsic semiconductor. Semiconductors can be divided into two parts, intrinsic and extrinsic semiconductors. Intrinsic semiconductors are very pure form of silicon or semiconductors. These semiconductors does not conduct at 0 degree Kelvin, and it can conduct at room temperature but having a very low current. So to have application of semiconductors, we need to dope it with either pentavalent or trivalent materials. If we dope it with pentavalent dopants, then we get a semiconductor having majority carriers as electrons, and if we dope it with trivalent materials, then we will get a semiconductor having majority as holes. As you can see here, in trivalent materials, all the three valence electrons are covalent bonded with neighboring silicon atoms, but one vacancy is there, so this is hole. And in the, this n-type material, or in which we have doped with a pentavalent material, we have a extra electron in this case. And these two are known as extrinsic semiconductors. This is a n-type semiconductor and this is a p-type semiconductor. So just see what is a n-type semiconductor. This is a doped silicon in which majority of the charge carriers are negatively charged electrons. And this is called n-type semiconductor. These are also known as donor type of semiconductor. In this, the majority carriers are free electrons and minority carriers are hole. Those are generated by thermal agitation. Now, this is a p-type semiconductors in which you can see this is a hole. So, this is known as a acceptor type of device in which hole is a majority carrier and electrons are of minority carriers. These electrons are generated by thermal ionization. So now just pause the video for a few seconds and recollect all the points that I have explained till now. Okay, so just after that that brief introduction about the semiconductor devices, now let's see what is a p-n junction. If you take a p-type of semiconductor and n-type of semiconductor, I mean we join it, then what happens that it creates a junction. And because in this type of semiconductor we have holes here and we have electrons here, and there is a concentration gradient of these two types of carriers, so electrons will be diffused to the p side and holes will be diffused to the n side to make a diffusion layer. Here these are the negative ions and these are the positive ions, and this is known as the space charge region or depletion region. And this includes the negatively and positively charged ions, and due to these ions we have electric field here, And due to that electric field, these electric fields will oppose the flow of electrons further into the p side and hold to the n side. So this is known as a p-n junction. And if we forward bias this device with a positive voltage to p side and negative voltage to n side, then depletion width will be reduced. And if we reverse bias it with negative voltage to the p side and positive voltage to the n side, then this region will increase. Now this is the symbol of the p-n junction diode. This is anode and this is cathode. This is, you can see that you can say that this is a p terminal. This is an n terminal, and this is a real diode that we can get in market. Okay, so hope so. I was able to give a bit brief intro about the semiconductor physics and the working of diode. Okay, if you like this video, then please comment and give suggestions to my email ID that is written over here. Thank you very much.